Hello and welcome to today's episode, which deals with the meaning of internet along with its advantages and risk. It will also tell you the OSI ISO reference model. In addition to it, the script also explains the history of internet, functions of internet, and how the internet can be used in business. I'm Shivangi Anand, and our subject expert for today's program is Nazia Hussain, teaching in Bangalore University. So let us start with the concept of internet. The internet can be defined as a large network that connects other networks of computers all around the world. An example of a single network of computers might be all the computers connected within the entire school district, using different applications such as email, telnet, and gopher. A user is allowed to interact with information found on the other computers connected to the internet. WWW is not the internet. The World Wide Web is only the portion of the internet. The WWW presents the information to the user via geographical browser like Netscape in the form of text, pictures, video, and even sound. History of the internet. The internet began as the ARPANET Advanced Research Projects Agency Net. It was developed by the US Department of Defense in conjunction with a number of military contractors and universities to explore the possibility of a communication network that could survive a nuclear attack. It continued simply because the people using it found that it provided a very convenient way to communicate. During the early 1980s, a major step in communication occurred as all the interconnected research networks were converted to TCP or IP, that is Transmission Control Protocol or the Internet Protocol. This enabled all the networks of the internet to send data back and forth, and the ARPANET became the backbone of the new internet, which completed all the TCP and IP based networks connected to the ARPANET. The conversion to TCP or IP was completed by the end of 1983, and thus the internet was born. How internet works. Internet is a global network of computers. Each computer connected to the internet must have a unique address. Internet addresses are in the form nnn.nnn.nnn.nnn, where nnn must be a number from 0 to 255. This address is known as an IP address. The picture below illustrates two computers connected to the internet, your computer with IP address 1.2.3.4 and another computer with IP address 5.6.7.8. The internet is represented as an abstract object in between. If you connect to the internet through an intranet service provider, that is ISP, you are usually assigned a temporary IP address for the duration of your dial-in session. If you connect to the internet from a local area network, that is LAN, your computer might have a permanent IP address, or it might obtain a temporary one from DHCP, which is Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol, server. In any case, if you are connected to the internet, your computer has a unique IP address. The internet is a network that connects thousands of individual computer networks. Each computer on the internet has a unique address. These addresses can be referred to as a number, which is called IP address, or a name called as domain name. For example, IP address 192.65.254.76 and domain name oregano.mwc.edu. Everything that is sent across the internet is a packet of data. Your email, live chats, web searches, and FTP sessions are all packets of data. The reason that the internet works at all is that every computer connected to it uses the same set of rulers for communication. Those set of rules are called protocols. The communication protocol used by internet is TCP or IP. The TCP, that is Transmission Control Protocol, part is responsible for dividing the file or the message into packets on the source computer. It is responsible for reassembling the received packets at the destination of recipient computer. The IP, that is Internet Protocol, part is responsible for handling the address of destination computer so that each packet is routed to its proper destination. If you were to follow the path that the message Hello Computer 5.6.7.8 took from our computer to the computer with IP address 5.6.7.8, Functions of Internet. Let us now see how Internet functions. First, at the source computer, the message or the file or the document to be sent to another computer is firstly divided into very small parts called packets. A packet generally contains up to 1500 characters. Second, each packet is given a number serial-wise, example 1.2.3. Third, all these packets are then sent to the address of destination computer. The destination computer receives the packet in random manner. If a packet is garbled or lost, it is demanded again. Fifth, the packets are reassembled in the order of their number and the original message or the file or the document is obtained. One of the greatest things about the internet is that nobody really owns it. It is a global connection of networks, both big and small. These networks connect together in many different ways to form the single entity that we know as the internet. In fact, the very name comes from the idea of interconnected networks. Internet is not governed by any particular body. It is coordinated by many volunteer organizations. There is no single authoritative organization. Various volunteer organizations are responsible for different types of activities as listed below. First, the Internet Architecture Board, that is IAAB, is responsible for or approving standards and allocating resources. Second, the Internet Engineering Task Force, that is IETF, is responsible for discussing and investigating the operational and technical problems of Internet. Third, the InterNIC is responsible for providing registration services to internet community. No one pays for the internet. There is no internet.inc that collects fees from the individual network. The NSV pays for nsv.net. Colleges and corporation pays for the connection to a regional network, which in turn pays a national provider for its access. There is a myth that the internet is free. It is not. Someone pays for every connection. Many times these fees are not passed on to the end user, and this feeds the illusion of free access. Advantages of internet. Email. Email is now an essential communication tool in business. It is also excellent for keeping in touch with family and friends. The advantage to email is that it is free when compared to telephone, fax, and postal services. Information. There is a huge amount of information available on the internet for just about every subject to man, ranging from government law and services, trade fairs and conferences, market information, new ideas, and technical support. Services. Many services are now provided on the internet, such as online banking, job seeking and applications, and hotel reservation. Often these services are not available offline or cost more. E-commerce. E-commerce is the concept used for any type of commercial business deals that involves the transfer of information across the globe via internet. It has become a phenomenon associated with any kind of shopping, almost anything. You name it, and e-commerce with its giant tentacles engulfing every single product and service will make you available at your doorsteps. It has got a real amazing and wide range of products from household needs, technology to entertainment. Online medical guidance. Several websites will also be on the web to obtain details about various conditions. You are able to consult with a cell of online physicians to obtain guidance about any medical problem. In addition, lots of material can also be available on the web for research in medical industry. Communication. Communities of all types have sprung upon the internet. It's a great way to meet up with the people of similar interest and discuss common issues. Online training. The facility is provided by the internet to obtain an online training. Several websites of different colleges offer lessons and classes on different subjects or subjects. You may also obtain these classes or lessons in your personal computer. You are able to have these classes repeatedly and obtain a large amount of understanding. It's very simple and cheap method to get training. Online results. Today, all of the training boards and colleges present results on the web. Their results can be watched by the students from any kind of nation or world. Advertisement. Today, products are advertised by most of the commercial organizations through internet. It's effective and inexpensive method for the marketing of goods. The services and products could be given lovely and attractive method to people around the world. Risks of internet. With all activities that give us almost unlimited freedom, there are risks. Because the internet is so easily accessible to anyone, it can be a dangerous place. Know who you are dealing with or what you are getting into. Predators, cyber criminals, bullies, and corrupt businesses will try to take advantage of the unwary visitor. Spamming. Spamming denotes distribution of unsolicited emails in large numbers. They are meaningless and they unnecessarily block the whole system. These activities are treated as illegal. Theft of personal details. While using the internet, there is high probability that your personal details like name, address, and credit card number may be accessed by con artists and used for fraudulent purposes. Pornography. Pornography is definitely harmful for your children. There are numerous pornographic sites available over the internet, and watching any of those can have very bad influence on the mental health of your children. Virus threat. Virus is a program that interrupts the usual operation of your personal computer system. PCs linked to the internet have high probability of virus attacks, and as a result of this, your hard disk can crash, giving you a lot of trouble. Applications of internet. Businesses use the internet to provide access to complex databases such as financial databases. Companies carry out electronic commerce including advertising, selling, buying, distributing products, and providing an after-sales service. Businesses and institutions use the internet for voice and video conferencing and other forms of communication that enable people to telecommunicate or work from home. The use of electronic mail over the internet has greatly speeded communication between companies, among co-workers, and between other individuals. Media and entertainment companies use the internet to broadcast audio and video, including live radio and television programs. They also offer online chat groups in which people carry on discussions using written text and online news and weather programs. Scientists and scholars use the internet to communicate with colleges to perform research, to distribute lecture notes and course materials to students, and to publish papers and articles. Individuals use the internet for communication, entertainment, finding information, and to buy and sell goods and services. Internet infrastructure. Telecommunication companies. Providing simple services such as phone calls to all types of customers. They are developing new technologies, fast switches for higher bandwidth communication across existing networks. Satellite technology. Vendors setting up new broadband network with global reach. Wireless technology. Provides internet facility at a faster pace, even on cell phones using wireless internet protocol. Cable companies provide two-way internet traffic on television by introducing set-top boxes, which act as converters and separators for the inbound and outbound traffic. Internet protocol suite. Protocols are software that perform variety of actions necessary for data transmission between computers. On the internet, protocol usually refers to a set of rules that define an exact format for communication between systems. Protocol is a precise definition of how computers interact with one another on a network. The protocols are based on the layers of the ISO or OSI, that is International Standards Organization, or Open System Interconnection, model of layers. Each layer is responsible for providing specific services or functions for computers exchanging information over a communication network, and information is passed from one layer to the next. The ISO model divides communicated function into 7 layers. First, physical layer. The physical layer describes the physical interface between devices and rules by which bits are passed from one device to another. Second, data link layer. The data link layer attempts to make the physical link reliable and provides the means to activate, maintain, and deactivate the link. It also provides the network layer with the reliable information transfer facility. Third, network layer. The basic services of network layer is to provide transparent transfer of data between transport entities. It includes the facility of network addressing and endpoint identification, network routing, service selection when different services are available. Fourth, transport layer. It is responsible for organizing reliable transfer of data between processes in different systems. Fifth, session layer. The session layer provides the mechanism for controlling the dialogue between two end systems. Presentation layer. It is responsible for the presentation of the data during transfer between two corresponding applications layer entities. Application layer. The application layer is responsible for providing user interface to network widely distributed information services. How can the internet be used in business process? Internet can be used in following business process. Enterprise resource planning. The business information system that integrate various functions of business are called enterprise resource planning. ERP systems originally evolved from manufacturing resource planning systems. ERP systems integrate many common applications into one systems. ERP system is an information system that supports several areas of business by containing a number of applications with a single database that stores all the data by applications. It plays an important role in any organization. ERP covers the techniques and concepts employed for integrated management of business as whole, from the viewpoint of the effective use of management resources to improve the efficiency of an enterprise. ERP systems are computer-based systems designed to process an organization's transactions and facilities integrated into a real-time planning production to improve the efficiency of an enterprise. Customer relationship management. CRM is the same as one-to-one marketing. This customer-focused business model also goes by the name relationship marketing, real-time marketing, customer intimacy, and a variety of other terms. But the idea is the same. Establish relationships with customers on an individual basis and then use the information you gather to treat different customers differently. The exchange between a customer and a company becomes mutually beneficial as customers give information in return for personalized services that meets their individual needs. The goals of CRM. Achieving long-running customer dialogue across all business functions and customer access points. More effective cross-selling and upselling increase customer retention and loyalty. Achieving higher responsiveness to marketing campaigns. Achieving higher customer profitability. Supply chain management. SCM is the process of strategically managing flows of goods, services, and knowledge along with relationships within and among organizations to achieve or support enterprise objectives. Supply chain management is the process of planning, implementing, and controlling the operation of the supply chain with the purpose to satisfy customer requirement as efficiently as possible. Selling chain management. It is the software that enables the development and successful development on large-scale field sales solutions that focus on automating many order acquisition functions, such as configuration, pricing, quoting, and service. The object of selling chain management is to allow customers to find the products they are looking for quickly and helps them find the solutions that they need for their business rapidly. Internet components. The following components enables developers to create applications, to communicate via the internet using a variety of protocols. The components either present an object interface or perform supporting functions such as email address validation. Some important components are domain name system. It provides the use of name to refer to hosts on the internet. DNS refers to domain name system and represents a powerful internet technology for converting domain names to IP addresses. Its special mission is to be a mediator between the IP addresses, the system side names of the websites and their respective domains, and their user side alphanumeric titles. Another important function of the DNS is to control the delivery of email messages. Email components use simple mail transfer protocol, post office protocol, and internet message access protocol. FTP, file transfer protocol, manages the movement of files across the internet. File upload and download components transfer files from host or from web pages to servers through HTTP and FTP. Hypertext transfer protocol creates application which can communicate using hypertext transfer protocol. Instant messaging and chat components allow users to chat and send messages. Internet protocol encryption. Components are used to encrypt and secure various internet protocols. Ping and ICMP. Components enable users to test network connectivity between two network nodes. Telnet. Components enable remote login and allow users to add terminal console capabilities. Network news transfer protocol enables user application to access news group through the internet. The basic internet software are the internet protocols that are running on most computers, including workstation, internet nodes, hosts, and intermediary nodes. Several types of software are required to access different services available on the internet. The basic software required to access internet are web browsing software. Web browsers like Netscape Communicator and Internet Explorer are software applications that request a page from web server and display it on the user's local computer. They receive HTML documents by using a uniform resource locator, which is the address of the file accessible on the World Wide Web. Browsers must be able to understand and interpret hypertext markup language codes in the HTML documents. Telnet software. Telnet is user command used to access a remote computer. Telnet software enables the user to log on to another computer and access any applications and data to which he or she has been granted. FTP software. A file transfer protocol program is used to download a file from the host computer to the PC or vice versa. FTP clients with graphical interfaces allow the user to drag and drop files from FTP site to a local computer. Web browsers like Netscape Communicator can also be used to issue FTP commands. Finger and ping utilities. Finger command provides a list of users who are logged onto a network. It is a program that runs on Unix operating system and allow a user to obtain some information about other network users. Ping provides data about connection between internet computers, such as number of connections. Ping is used to troubleshoot internet connections. The command is given as ping followed by IP address in MS-DOS window. Tracer and route tracing program. Tracer provides an indication of time it takes a message to travel from one computer to another and back. Route tracing programs calculate and display the number of nodes between computers and the time it takes to traverse the entire one-way path between machines. Let us quickly summarize what we have learned today. The internet can be defined as a large network that connects other networks of computers all around the world. An example of a single network of computers might be all the computers connected within the entire school district. There is tens of thousands of these networks communicating with one another using different applications such as email, Telnet, and Gopher. A user is allowed to interact with information found on the other computers connected to the internet. The internet began as the ARPANET, Advanced Research Projects Agency Net. It was developed by the US Department of Defense in conjunction with a number of military contractors and universities to explore the possibility of a communication network that could survive a nuclear attack. It continued simply because the people using it found that it provided a very convenient way to communicate. Internet is a global network of computers. Each computer connected to the internet must have a unique address. Internet addresses are in the form nnn.nnn.nnn.nnn, where nnn must be a number from 0 to 255. This address is known as an IP address. One of the greatest things about internet is that nobody really owns it. It is a global connection of networks, both big and small. These networks connect together in many different ways to form the single entity that we know as the internet. In fact, the very name comes from the idea of interconnected networks. That is all for today. Hope you have understood the life concept of internet. We'll see you again with another topics on computer. Till then, take care. Bye.